All right, well, the discussions of, I think I have to make a discussion. My gosh, family dog, not really family dog, but my brother's dog died. She was very long lived, I think 15 years, so it's a note, a miss. We're gonna miss her. What else happened? My gosh. And then a very old friend, her mother died, an old friend of my mother's. Her mother died recently, just last week, so it's been a lot of deaths all of a sudden. It's weird, isn't it? And I'm like, well, okay, I'm starting this beading. And I know what I mean, beading, I mean beads, like the purchase of beads. And I am kind of oddly living in disappointment right now, because I went to, I don't know, a big shopping spree. And the big shopping spree doesn't really bring you a lot, you know. Okay, like this is here. See this? These are like, this is one hank's worth, and that's pretty much the same as this. Okay, now the hank is this one is like the necklace. This is the Czech glass style, and then this is also another glass style. These are all glass beads, but yeah, so they don't give you very much. And then I drop them on the floor, and so I had to pick them all up, and I literally have to pick them all. Oh, and then the big terrible is, you know, I'm like brain, I'm supposed to be smart, right? And I'm like, I'm going down on the number scale, and I wasn't thinking about the point this time around. I was just going, well, that one's it goes 6, it goes 8, it goes 11, it goes 15, and 15 would be the finest. You know, my brain was doing that. So I'm like, I definitely do not want the finest. But then after the order arrived, I'm like, oh no, they really meant in point millimeter. So in point millimeter, it goes the 6, the 8, the 0.15, the 0.11, so I ended up with all of the dinky dinky tiny ones. So now I'm like, uh-oh, crud. See, there's a hank, there's one in the hank. So yeah, and you know, whoa, on the ice. Yeah, and so they do this, and they get all over the place. And I'm not really a twister. I've decided I'm not going to be a twister seller, where you just buy these and you twist them and you put them in a thing. And then you wear them around your neck, because people do that, you know. They just become twister sellers, twisters, and yuck. So, and so what else happened? Well, in all of this excitement, I feel like I got some pearls. They're really big ones, and they're just kind of cheesy looking. But oh shoot, there's one on the ground. Yeah, I mean, fortunes. This is like a small fortune. These items. So, oh my gosh, I'm like panicked. And so now I'm looking at all these bracelets out there and all these patterns, and like, I don't want them to be so needy for beads, because these things are pricey. I mean, it's like $3. This was $3, and I got it on discount. That was $3. And, you know, $3 or more. So anyway, so I made a few things already. I made a fish, okay? Now, don't ask, but I did. I made a funny fish. He has, I don't know if you can see it. But yeah, he's there, being silly. And I guess he's just something you wear around your neck. Like, hey, I got a fish. Oh my gosh, here I am with my funny thing. Yeah, I got a fish. But, you know, he doesn't work in this light. He's really, really brilliant, though. He's brilliantly checky glass. And what I did in this one is I surrounded him. It's just like a crystal inside. And so you can hang him up in the window. So he's almost more a window fish than a werefish, because you can see all the way through him, like with your eyeball. You can't really, but the light can. So the crystal fish is just a funny idea I had. Alright, so I'll put him away. But yeah, when you look down on him, you can see he's got two eyes that way. So he really is a fish. See that? He really is a cool magoo. And he's all sewed. I sewed him with just needle and thread. And then after, I'm like, uh-oh, this isn't always working. The thread pops. And so I'm like, okay, since the thread is popping, now, then I'm losing all the beadwork. I end up having to go to that nylon thread. I got the nylon thread also. And the nylon thread is good, but, you know, it's just not fun to handle. It's not as fun as regular thread. It's just cranky, okay? Okay, and then I made this one. Now, this one is motley, a motley bead. It really is sewn, another one sewn, but it's all wonky. I could not get the pattern, like, to go into the spots exact. I haven't figured that out. I haven't found the tutorial. That part of my brain is dead, that I can't figure out how to get the bead into the every other slot. And so I really made a bad one. It's kind of motley. So this is a motley bead. It's okay, but you know, it's not perfect. You know what I say? It's not round. It's got things sticking out, and I made, you know, strange shapes, so it's not fun. But my very first attempt, though, was actually better. It was a smooth one, more like a blackberry. So here's like a, gosh dang it. He's so dark, though. My blackberry one is so dark, you can't see it. Yeah, so anyway, so he's just on a pin at the moment. I don't have him on anything. But no, it's still not in the slots. I did not put the little berry in the right place. So this is not like pro, you know what I'm saying? It looks pro. Ooh, I made a bead. But it's not pro, okay? It's not on all the slots. Right now it's just like a disco ball that, I don't know, you twirl somewhere. And then I made one today, another type. Now this was with the zebra wire. I got that wire and I was like all excited with it. And then as soon as I touched the pliers to it, and I love the wire, it's very pretty colors. If you touch the pliers to it too many times, the color just goes to copper again. And so once that happens, when it goes to copper again, you ruin your entire design. Because you're like, what happened? Now copper shows up, and I didn't want copper. I only wanted the green color. But anyway, so now I have to invest in some kind of enamel purchase to dot it up. So anyway, so this design is the same thing. It's a ball. So I went around a ball, and dun, 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 but I beaded this, the glass. So I beaded the glass, then twisted, and then crimped it around, and then so you made some kind of funny design. These things take forever. I'm not excited by this process. This took longer. This one took, you know, and that's like the game we are at here. It's like, you know, you all buy the one that takes a longer time. You know, that's the man hour, the woman hours. You know, or you take the one that was the less time that looks a little cooler. And yeah, this one looks a little cooler. And I mean, like, it's like a little filia for a lamp or something, also. Or a tassel. These could be on tassels. I don't get this deal. But, so yeah. So they're pushing me to make these funny things, sewing them. And then they're very bead intensive, and I'm losing my beads already, you know, my supply. They take a lot of beads. Just this one, just 8 beads. I just ate a lot of those little amethyst ones, the lavenders. So I'm kind of bummed out. It's almost like it, you know, it takes like one of these. I know I'm exaggerating, but maybe almost a little over a half, definitely. Maybe even a whole 3/4 of it. Now this is like the Toho kind, and I haven't really used them yet. Yeah, they're just smaller. They're just smaller little, these ones are like $1. Well, you can get them for like $1.50. But they're smaller quantity, much smaller quantity. But yeah, I mean, these are cool if I could get it right. And then I'm like, well, 5 hours later, I didn't. And then maybe it took me, you know, when I'm doing the bead correctly, it would be 5 hours, you know, at least. And these women have these like entire necklaces. And then I saw one lady online. She's selling, here's her necklace, and she's selling it for $45. And I'm like, well, How do you gauge that? If it took you 5 hours to sew the bead and it has like five beads on it, how is that plausible that you're selling it for $45? It just doesn't seem possible. Because it definitely took her longer than ever, you know. Took her a long dang time, you know. Takes her practically a week to do that. You know, so she's now saying her prices are 40, she's $45 a week, you know. I mean, that's her wage if she sells it, you know. So it's kind of a yuck. It's a yucky situation. So I'm not really happy with the bead sellers out there being so cheap. Yeah. I mean, come on. This is terrible. I mean, these women are making these elaborate bracelets because they have just all the time in the world, you know, and maybe they're retired or whatever, and blah, blah, blah. And so, well, it doesn't matter the price, you know. You know, so we have them, and then we have the other ones who live in like Latvia, and well, it doesn't matter the price. Well, their prices are different. And so they can get away with it, you know, being really cheap, $45 a week. But yeah, I mean, crummy. And anyway, don't get the size 11. It's very pretty, it's fine. It's good for fine jewelry, but it's almost too fine. I don't know. I can't say that, can I? I can't say don't get it because maybe somebody really needs it. I don't know. I did the wrong thing. What does work though is the size 26 gauge zebra wire, and not the 24, the 26. I don't think the 24 worked. I have to retest it. I also got some 20 zebra, but yeah. So now I've got to learn about this zebra because when you crimp it, the paint falls off. Darn it, because it comes in these really beautiful colors. There's like the green. See that one? Yeah, very beautiful colors. So I don't know. Anyway, so I'm thought like, okay, what else can I do with beads? You know, so I have to make money out of these things. You know, make money appear. I thought maybe headbands. I can make headbands. I've done that. I can knit a headband and then put beads on it. That's an idea. And then, oh, I can make the cell phone carriers where you carry your cell phone in it. I can make those, but I don't have a sewing machine. And so I don't really want to knit everything I mean, sew everything by hand. So I'd have to knit them, you know. So I'd have to make knitted cell phone carriers. I'm really tired of being the machine already. When I say the machine, it does feel like being the machine, doesn't it? When you get into like this handwork craft style, it just feels like you're starting to be a machine you know, a lot of that goes through my head, all of the work that's been going on, like in China. You know, to get things over here, like a little beaded purse or whatever, you know, how much work, you know, how many people actually made it, and was it just one person? I see a lot of things out here online, and I wonder, is it, you know, somebody did that. Obviously, they were paid very, very low wage, and it's just the same here, you know, it's just the same here. So I'm not even seeing a difference anymore. Low wage, low schmage. That's all. Any hoot. They say that the average wage in San Francisco is $70,000. I'm like, what the heck? Doesn't seem like that. Doesn't seem like that. It seems like that is a scam. That's a lie also. I do not believe it is $70,000. I think people just hang around in their houses on their house money and go, lucky me. I think that's what they do more. Yeah. Well, anyway. Dun, 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 dun. So I made a blackberry bead. Oh, I'm starting the song Lakme. What's what is that cutesy one? The bell, the la clochette. Où va la jeune andu? Yeah, it's a French one, but it's not slow. It's not a legato. It's Fide Peria. Trying to learn it, but quand la lune se jouait dans le grand mimosa. Yeah, that one. Anyways, it's not French sounding at all, because it's very soprano, it's very hypey. Like a little dog, like a hypey little dog. Yeah, it's one of those songs. So anyway, if anybody wants to know what happened to her, well, she's the coloratura and her brain cells popped. How about that? She sings too high. Darr. You know, they probably could do one of those, like a test, and go, oh my god, too much air in her head, like forever. It's too late. It's just too late. Anyway, funny me. A blackberry. Oh, yeah, I know. I could do that like Ingeborg. I could tape it. She's an old ballet mistress, director of mine. I could just tape it up. It won't drop. Gosh, dang it! I'm so young. Anyway, condolences to little Stelilita. I love her. My gosh, too bad. Too bad. Yeah, too bad. And then, yeah, and the mamacita went. Okay.